Hey there. How's it going? I got my gloves out today because it's very cold out. I'm having a reprieve from the cold temperatures. But here is my vlog on Christianity. This is AugustusLarch. Christianity. I was a devout Christian for many years. I went to church every Sunday. Every Sunday in March. Every Sunday in January and November. Why? Because I was very devout. I prayed to this God every day to help me. And later on, when I got an education and read a significant amount of literature and studied things like psychology, I found out that this God person was really messed up. He is a jealous God. And he's a deity and responsible for everything good. That's a bit of a contradiction. And he's established a religion based on fear. People might look at gothic people and say, what is wrong with that person? Well, maybe they have a little Rosetta Stone on how the real world works. Let's force you by fear and reward. Classic conditioning, And operant conditioning, but don't they work in polar opposites? Really now. Either you believe what we have to say, or you will perish for all eternity. You will die every day forever. You will never actually die. You will just be tormented for all eternity. Or you can be rewarded for all eternity. Which do you choose? There is sheep and there is goats, right? Wouldn't you rather be a sheep and just follow along? Follow right along. There's something wrong with that, actually, isn't there now? When I look at it, at the real text of the Bible that Emperor Constantine decided to allow publishing rights, you know, he allowed it to be published, or else it wouldn't have been. Had a couple of key battles there. Didn't he kill the right people? Ambitious for power. Oh, Constantine, what a perfect individual. He's a person that should choose what books of the Bible we should read. Isn't that right? A person that marched with the cross in front of his columns and cut down non-combatant opponents because, well, that's God's way. Pizarro knocking down millions of Inca. They're heathens. That's what Christianity is all about, is it not? Because we follow this bloodthirsty God. He wants your sacrifice of blood. He wants your firstborn. At the last moment, he'll relent because he's that kind of person, but he kept this pendulous drama over you for all that time, and then he keeps doing it, and he supposedly does it to his own son as well. He's got a penchant for infanticide. He's a God controlling everything, responsible for all that happens, but he lets the Egyptians cut down all the infants, hoping to find that Moses character. What did Satan do? He challenged that person who was envious, who demanded exacting tributes, who wanted your firstborn's blood to be spilled for his honor. That's the kind of guy that I applaud a little bit, this supposed Satan guy. And who did they model him from? Oh, Prometheus. What did Prometheus do? He tried to give the humanity some tool against the people that were using them as a real-time diorama. Oh, what a violation. What a violation. And here's Satan. The only thing he says, you know, you've created all these people, but they're all warlords. I mean, Noah, Abraham, Job, don't they make their money knocking people over and being more powerful because their God is more powerful? And they make little sacrifices and said, look how powerful my God is. as my little army wipes out your camp. It's powerful. And what did Satan do in Job? The supposed Satan, or Prometheus, or for those who have more canon philosophy behind that, Enki. He said, well, this Job person, you rewarded him forever. Let's see him get some adversity and see if he still worships you. And take the publisher's note on this, that they decide what ink gets put on the page now, right? But even then, Satan is a person who doesn't do anything bad to Job. All he does is bargain with God, and he provokes a madman to make his perfect person, his one he rewarded that followed every command, suffer horribly. And after all this, Job still says, I will not curse God. And Satan says, whatever, man, you're better than me, and falls into the shadows. Until later on when he killed Jesus on the cross, I guess. But anyway, who's the real bad guy there? Read the text. God made everything happen to Job. It wasn't Satan. The only thing Satan did was say, if he has adversity, he might not be so friendly to you, to your idea, God. Well, the publisher's pen, Constantine and King James, ambitious, power-hungry monarchs in antiquity still drive us today. Let's worship Jesus because no matter what we do, we'll always be forgiven. If we say our rosary today, oh my goodness, you know what? We still have a place in heaven. She just said her rosary. Well, the last rites have already been done for that individual, I tell you what. I can just do them, but I'll just be going through the motions. If she's that devout, she's probably going on to heaven. And everybody can live, and everybody in the community. She did her rosary before she died.
What? Oh my freaking God! And the, who is the centurion, Longinus or something? Who speared, okay, he's blind. And he commands 100 Roman troops. But he's blind and he still has the job. And he spears Jesus and the blood falls into his eyes and he's cured of his blindness. Ooh! What folklore we have.
Most of the stuff with Lucifer and Satan and whatnot is mysticism. It's not even in the Gnostic Bible. It's not in the Apocrypha. Oh yeah, Constantine. It wasn't really the caveman time when Christianity was put together. No. There was very detailed records, and the copies still exist. That's why they had the Apocrypha. That's what Constantine rejected from the Bible. So this is AugustusLarch, and we're discussing theology and philosophy tonight, and religion. Join us in this discussion. Well, you have. Thank you for watching YouTube. This is AugustusLarch.